Hey guys, this is Janine from Pangolin. Thank you for tuning back into my Lightroom course. If you've missed the previous modules, feel free to sign up on our homepage for the full Lightroom course for wildlife photographer. It's for free. Today I want to tackle how to import images into Lightroom. Let's get started. That an SD card, or maybe a CF card, CFast card, XQD card, whatever card your camera takes, and we would be stuck with having to download our images. So first, you definitely need a card reader. A lot of computers have a SD card slot here on the side. Some computers only have a USB-C stick nowadays. Then you need different adapters such as that. And now it depends, do you work from a desktop? Then you can load them straight into your desktop if you have enough space. But if you're working from a laptop, which you usually do when you're on a trip, for instance, make sure that you have enough external hard drive space with you. An external hard drive will make sure that your laptop space doesn't get full too quickly, because once your laptop is full and jammed up, it refuses to work smoothly. And then it's also difficult to reverse, because as you're trying to get the files back off your laptop simply works so slowly, there is not enough RAM left and it struggles. If you do travel a lot and you're bouncing around with your camera gear in a laptop, maybe think about buying an SSD card. SanDisk, Toshiba, WD all have fabulous SSD cards, and those just don't break as easily. So if you travel a lot and bounce around a lot, or you're simply a clumsy person, you want to make sure your images are safe. Make sure you get you a hard drive that can take the beating. So let's get started. Make sure you're going to get yourself a card reader. And make sure you connect your hard drive. I've taken this little tip from my partner. I have a Velcro here on the back so that my hard drives don't dangle around with my laptop as I carry it around. And you would just connect it. So this is my SD card. And you will find the exact same images on our homepage to download if you want to try and do it alongside me. And this is my hard drive. And I get a lot of guests that just take the images straight off their SD card and will either copy and paste it onto the hard drive, or even worse, straight onto their picture folder on their computer. However, now that we have Lightroom, we do not need to take that extra step to import our pictures into Lightroom. Rather than shifting them manually onto our device, we can make Lightroom our tool to import them and shift them at the very same time. So as you connect your memory stick, you would usually have an import window open in Lightroom automatically. If that doesn't happen, you can simply drag and drop your files, either the whole folder or the files individually, onto your Lightroom icon, and Lightroom will open this dialog window for you. Last but not least, if you're in Lightroom itself, you can press File, use a drop-down menu to go to the icon Import Photos and Videos. Again, our import dialog will open, but it will not select the right pictures yet. We now have to select the source. Where do you want the pictures from? It would be straight off our LR course SD card. So on the left side, you choose from where you want to shift the images. And on the right side, you choose to where you want to shift the images. In my case, I always shift them to my external hard drive, which is always called JK Photos. I keep the name identical for all my hard drives so that it looks like one hierarchy structure in Lightroom. And then you need to choose the way you want to move the pictures from A to B. So you can do that by copying them, which is usually the safest way. You do not want to move them, because if something goes wrong in the process of moving the pictures from A to B, you don't want them to be lost. If they're copied, then they will always still be on the card and you can format the card afterwards. You can also copy them as a DNG. That means you have a more general RAW format, but every camera has their own RAW formats that work just fine. So generally, I would choose copy. You can check out each image individually in large. However, loading them from the SD card directly usually takes a while. So just importing them and looking at them in your library afterwards is the faster way of reviewing your images. You can check them all, uncheck them all, check them individually, depending on which image you want to have imported. So in summary, you can move your images from your SD card straight to the end location without having to shift them to your computer first, which saves you quite a lot of time, especially if your RAM is rather low. On a side note, a high amount of RAM, 16 gigabyte and more, will help you tremendously with your workflow of going through your images. If you have downloaded the images from our homepage, simply choose other source and choose your files from your download icon to import them together with me. After choosing the source as well as the final destination, we have a few options of how to handle and import the files that I want to go through with you. So what is our file handling? When we import images, we build previews, which are little thumbnails which you can look at in case your hard drive isn't connected or your images are not close by. The size of your preview will determine how quickly your import processes. Obviously, you can see the most detail on a one-on-one preview, but it also will take the longest to import. Secondly, you can build something called smart previews. Smart previews have the ability that you can edit your files even if the original file isn't with you. So if you do not have your external hard drive close by, you left it at home in your safe, you can still work and edit on your files. How does that work? As I have explained in a different module, we never edit and work in our original files. What we would do is whenever we create a change, we have a little .xmp file created, which is a text file. So with our smart previews, that .xmp file will be created. And later on, once your hard drive is connected, it will be allocated to the original file that it belongs to. So I like to always build smart previews. Please remember, if you go through the process of deleting old backups of your Lightroom, you might lose your smart preview. You will not lose your XMP files or your original files, but the option to work in a file that is not physically present might be gone. You have the option to tick don't import suspected duplicates. That means if you have downloaded a memory card previously, you put it back into your camera and you forgot to format the memory card. The next day you place it in your card reader in order to download your images, you can press don't import suspected duplicates and it will only import the new images. You'll see these images have all been added to my catalog previously, so they all start graying out if they have been imported previously. This only holds if you haven't gone through the images already and deleted them again, because obviously if the images have been deleted, they will be added back to your catalog, which is really annoying because now you have to do double the work. You can make a second copy straight to a second hard drive to have a backup immediately. And you can also immediately add it to a collection. For me, this doesn't work for my workflow as my collections usually only hold the best of files, but that I will teach you in a different module. Our next drop-down menu is with regards to file renaming. You can rename your files by dates, you can custom name it, you can have any file name you would like. I really don't mind much about my file name initially, so I keep it as it is. Furthermore, you have options to apply certain settings during the import already. So you can change your color space, your grain, your sharpening, etc. as you are importing your images. So you don't have to do it afterwards. However, I find that wildlife photography is so versatile that there's generally not one preset that you can make use of to apply to all of the different light conditions and animals you might have photographed. If there is, usually it would be a preset that you have created previously, and I will show you how to create presets in a different module to be applied during import afterwards as well. You can add your metadata. Metadata makes sense if you worry that your images are stolen either from social media or during competitions or any other way. You create the metadata by pressing New. You can give it a title, Lightroom Course Beginners. And usually you would not have to fill in all these different options. Your most important is your basic info, your IPTC copyright, saying that this image is yours and that may not be used without written consent, as well as your IPTC creator. Those are your most important metadata information. Which camera it has been shot on and what settings it has been shot with will automatically be imported with the image. You then create your metadata, and you can choose it to be imported straight with your image. It will not show on your image, but it will be embedded in your image to make sure you can prove that was an image that you have shot. You can also add keywords to start with. That will save you a tremendous amount of time. We have four different subjects here: an elephant baby, a pike kingfisher, an adult elephant dusting, and a fish eagle. So you cannot specifically say which animal you have, but you could say that it was shot in Chobe, in Botswana, and that is a wildlife shot. Now to the final drawing card, your destination. So I've already chosen that I would like to import these images to my external hard drive. You might choose a different place for the tutorial purpose. That depends and is up to you. In my previous module, I have talked about file ordering. So before you choose a destination, you need to make sure that you know how you want to organize your files. Because if you keep the same file structure throughout your entire Lightroom library, it will be organized and your images will be more easy to find. If you have 10 different hard drives and different folder structures, on this one you have it chronological, and on this one you have topics, and this one is a trip to Kenya, then it will be very difficult to find your images afterwards. So Lightroom gives you the option to organize it by date automatically. If your timestamp on your cameras is correct, this is a beautiful way of organizing it. You can also keep it in the original DCMI folder, or you just dump all your images in one folder, which I would not suggest. So I usually keep it by date, and then you have a lot of different options how you want to have your drop-down menus appear. You can have the year and the specific day as a twofold drop-down menu. You can have the year and the month as a twofold drop-down menu. You can have a threefold drop-down menu that displays the year, the month, as well as the day. Or you simply have it day by day. So it depends on you how you would like to visualize your folder structure. And I have chosen a threefold drop-down menu. It really depends on what you prefer. If you do like to keep your images in topics, you can also choose a subfolder with a topic such as Chobe 2019, and then you have it chronologically imported afterwards. But because I'm making use of collections, I feel the need for subfolders in my file structure is not necessary, and I personally only import it by date. Once you're done with that, you're going to press import, and you will see a little working bar appear up there that will show the progress. I have two of them because one of them copies and imports the photos and one of them builds my previews. I will soon have a third one appear that will build my smart previews. There we go, 21 out of 24. And once the whole process is complete, I will have Lightroom inform me about it and I can press OK. I really hope you got a better idea on how to transfer data from A to B. You really do not need to move this data through your computer. The only way you need to move it is through Lightroom. I do not touch my images unless my Lightroom Classic is open. That is my tool to work with my images and to go through my images. If your images are not on SD cards anymore, but you have a whole existing folder structure on your hard drive or on your computer, and you want to know how to get started with Lightroom, this will be in a different module. Check out the link below and you'll be able to get started completely fresh with the existing images you have. Bye-bye.